Tanubole so mama, osisi, obuti, Sunday school. Ngelihle igama lomfelo wami uJesu Kristu waseNazaretha. Ngokukhethekile ngithanda ukubulisa ingelozi yakulendle. Hayi, saze sathandwa amaZulu, sabusiswa ngengelozi enhle kangaka. Yes, sithanda ukubulisa mama and wishing you a belated birthday. Siyabonga uNkulunkulu ngokugqina aqinile thina. And we also pray that he blesses you with many more years. Amen. Are there any new visitors in the house this morning? Mabebe khona ngicela ba wave so we can embrace and love them. Oh, baseza. Okay, that's good. I'm here this morning to encourage all of us. Ngicela ukushare something ehlele enhlizweni yami that I really feel like I should share. Amen. I'm here this morning to encourage all of us to lift up the white flag and be a symbol of hope. I don't know if you all have noticed, but there is a global agenda that is between good and evil. That is between light and darkness, that is between virtue and vice. Today, the forces of evil are so organized and actively promoting their agenda worldwide. Today, a song that speaks about being unholy is one of the most popular songs in the modern times. Today, darkness has become so socially acceptable that darkness doesn't need to hide itself anymore. It used to be that, at very least, the people who were the purveyors of darkness had to find a way to cloak it. They had to find a way to blend it into the world. But today they are all around us, they are everywhere, all day, every day. Just a decade or two ago, the debates were centered around, you know, issues like global warming or renewable energies. But now we are embroiled in discussions, you know, of whether or not gender is a science or a feeling. Today, the institution of a family has come under attack. Today, scientists are finding ways to have two male rats mate and create offsprings. We are skating dangerously thin on the ice of darkness, and we don't seem to understand what is it that we're doing. We are busy rewriting the rules and the laws. And in amongst all of this, we are debating of whether or not there is God. We have people trying to convince us that religion is a scam. But you may have a different view on this, and you are welcome to it. But let's make it clear this morning that whilst we are debating of whether or not there is a fight between light and darkness, those who are the true merchants of darkness are very clear there is. And not just that, they have a playbook. They've got a strategy. Those are the people that John the Baptist mentions in 1 John chapter 2, verse 19, when he says, "They went from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us. But they went out that they might be made manifest that they were not all of us." We are busy debating of whether or not there is genocide, there is war taking place. They are busy asking themselves, what's the next phase in the war? Those are the people who are coming into your children and my siblings' schools, trying to indoctrinate them with destructive ideologies. And if you dare speak up, you're called anti-progressive. If you dare speak up, you're called old. If you dare speak up, you're called conservative. If you dare speak up, you're called traditional. Just so we are clear, if standing for traditional values, if standing for a value of a family, and if standing for goodness makes me conservative, makes you conservative, I guess, then put me on the list. We live in an age of not just physical, but spiritual darkness too. And to those of you who strive to bring light into the world, may you remain vigilant, because the enemy finds a way to come and dim your light. And he does it in the most intrusive ways. He comes into your most intimate space. He comes and sows a seed of doubt. He comes and sows a seed of distrust. He comes and sows a seed of hatred. I'm here this morning to urge all of us to wake up if you are not paying attention. Because the only ones who seems not to have a playbook are the good ones. The only ones who don't seem to understand the war is current and the war is intentional are the good ones. They are the ones whose responsibility is to light up the darkness, to lift up the white flag and be a symbol of hope. Your job is to instill hope, it's to inspire, it is to educate and share with children the values that are going to make them men and women. The men and women who understand that you don't just win a fight unless you show up for it. And perhaps it's time we show up for that fight. This is the moment. I do feel strongly that this is a conversation we need to have. And it's very necessary for us to have as well. Especially at the time where the world and our country is gearing up for the elections. This is the moment where we need to be asking ourselves questions of whether the leaders we will be electing in the next coming weeks are the reflection of the future we all pray for. Perhaps simply going on in our knees and getting innocent with the Lord through prayer. But we also need to get into harmony with our dreams by taking the right actions. This is the moment for us, for all of us. This is the season to recognize that we're standing today at the gates that could potentially lead us into slavery if we make a wrong move. And I pray that the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, guide your hearts and your minds as we will be going to the voting polls. In Jesus Christ, amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. I greet you all, Bazalwane, in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And so I'd like to extend a special greeting to Obed-Degel, aka the angel of the house. Happy belated, Ma. And I think Umiya was speaking for all of us when he said we truly love and appreciate you. And it's such a privilege to serve under your leadership. Amen. This morning I've been sent to collect the offering. Amen. So if you have a Bible, greetings to everybody else in the church. Amen. So if you have a Bible, please go with me to the book of Matthew chapter 2. I'm going to read to verse 1 and 2, then we're going to jump on to verse 11. Amen. Chapter 2, verse 1 reads, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, where is the one who has been born king of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him. And then verse 11 says, on coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Amen. I think a lot has been said about offering, giving in the space of church. So I believe all of us really have sort of grasped the concept of giving. Amen. For many of us, we know when to give, we know how to give, and we probably also know what to give. I mean, there's tithing, you know you have to tithe, you know it's 10% of whatever it is, and you know every Sunday you're almost asked to give something at church, amen? But I think many of us have actually not realize who we are giving to. Amen. And because of that, our giving has become more of a religious act that we do at church, instead of it being from a point of revelation as to who we are giving to. Amen. Hence, you find someone debating within themselves, which is, am I supposed to pay 10% of my gross income or 10% of my net income? Or am I supposed to give 100 rand every Sunday or give 200 rand, whatever the case might be? And that tells me it's really become a religious thing that you know you have to give. And we've actually limited our giving just to money. Amen. But when we look at the story of this monkey that were coming from the east, first of all, they received revelation of who was born. They realized that he who was born was a king. And so their giving was from a point of revelation of who they were giving to rather than what they were going to present to them. And I would like to believe it was maybe a culture or something that was a norm that whenever a child is born, they give and do all of those things. But their kind of giving in this case was inspired by a revelation of who Jesus was. And I just pray this morning that may we move away from a religious kind of giving. And let's not limit our giving to just money. Yes, the church might need money every now and then, but may we not limit our giving just to money. There's so many other things that you can give. You can give your time. You can give your expertise to the church. But you can only do that from a point of revelation when God speaks to you as to what you need to give. Amen. May I kindly invite us to stand and do the declaration as I come. Hallelujah. We are a blessed church. We are a blessed church. We give from an overflow. We give in abundance. Hallelujah. May we hold our offering as I pray. Dear kind and heavenly Father, we thank you this morning for this opportunity to give that you have given unto us. We do realize, Wuti, we've been giving from a religious point of view, but this morning, oh God, we pray that may our giving be transformed. May we give from a revelation of who you are, oh God. And I just pray this morning, oh God, that whatever it is that has been grabbing hold of our minds, that has limited us from fully trusting you with our giving, that has made us to be hesitant in listening to your voice where our giving is concerned, we pray this morning and Wednesday by the power of the Holy Spirit. And as we give this morning, we pray that may you bless each and every hand that give. And those of us who haven't had the privilege to give this morning, oh God, we pray that may you extend a blessing to us that we may be able to give in the future. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The ushers are going to circulate the baskets for us to give us alone and be blessed. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can we praise the Lord this morning? Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I have the victory. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I have the victory. In the name of Jesus.
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 I have a victory.
In the name of Jesus,
I have the victory.
In the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
I have the victory.
I have victory.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus.
Victory.
When I call
in the name.
one can stand before you. No one can stand before you. I call upon the name
Jesus.
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 I have the victory.
I have the victory.
Glorious name,
Jesus.
Jesus.
I am a
stone banana fortress. Hallelujah. I have the victory. I have the victory. You are the mighty warrior. You're great in battle. Jehovah is your name. Mighty warrior, great in battle, Jehovah is your name. You're the mighty warrior.
Mighty warrior.
Great in battle.
Great in battle.
Jehovah is your name.
Jehovah
is your name. Right in our
Him the glory, worship Him. He's the great I am. Akekho njengaye. Yena yedwa sinqobelayo. Yena yedwa omili kunaphakade. We worship your name, glorious God. Hallelujah, Jehovah is your name.
Hallelujah. Come on, if you can just open your mouth and say something to great Jesus. Come on, everyone. Can you just pray and give him praise? We glorify you, ekuseni Nkulunkulu wethu. We thank you and we honor you. Akekho njengawe. Come on, bazalwana, I need to hear you saying something to Jesus. He is worthy of all glory and honor, of all adoration, of all praises. King forever. No one can compare to him. He is glorious in all his ways. Oh, there is no fault in him. Oh, nothing is ever lost in his hands. Hinasha nakapatosi anamaye nase lebra kotere bando zede alasa iana mama mama shena na 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 si alaka. We bless you, Lord. We bless you. We bless you. We bless you. Exen. Inamando celebre hede hasaya. Elabanda ya kada mandanda namasete. Yikapato zonde nandandana. Yebongosi. Sipamwake xeni. Ishana mana na nasha. Rekete beyela mana. Yenana yenana mana na na nasha. Yela basa katadere. Rababo jekede se e. Elamakato zodeka. Rabababababa shana kadasene. Yela mando kapata hasataha. Hila mande shiande kasia. Rababa shiande kete tekete. Rikoto kapata kasete. Hinda manda yela bababa shadaha. Yeleba sande ya hadasa ya hateka. Yela mashande kapatasia ha. Hila baka toko toseta. Hila baka paka tahata. Jehovah Kulum, Jehovah Ngwele, Jehovah Musa, Sizegu Ekseni, Hila Manda Hanasi Ahanaya, Usene Mele Medeke, Rabakataya Labasha, Reketeke Bandose, Hila Manda Yela Bababa, Rakapakatayele, Rekotama Ana Adese, Hila Basha Daba Asaf, Hikapata Hede Maham, Yela Basete Hede Kesef, Rika Pahataya La Masham, Rindo Zoko Pap, Zindekete Keteze, Zimana Hasam, Yila Bashaha, Ehena, Yila Makato Sota, Yibanda Sahab, Rika Pakato Zo, Zimana Sata, Yila Bashata, Yibakato So, Yemanda Kasata Kakatata, Sendekete, Yila Basha, Yimana Nana Nana Sana Yende, Yeleba Kato Yela Basayata, Yibaka Pakote Yala Manda, Yemando Se, Rakapatasa, Yila Baseteke, Rando Koseke, Rapakata Kakate, Sana Manda Nanda, Yeleba Shakataka, Yibazuka Pakate, Yeleba Setete, Rakoto Patasata, Imanda kasayala, yelaba sata, yelebe sheke, rapakotosha, ramakataka, repeketeke, inda mandanda, shakapakata, yeleba sata, inda masehe, imamandaka, yelaba sa, yelebe she, yikapata, yekapato, rapakasa, usanana mama mama mayanana. Elabasata, Yilabashetekete, Repeketa Tatasa, Yilamana Nana Nana, Yekasona Mama Mama Yehem, Yelabasakatapa, Reketeketaha, Yelamana Sayaha, Yilababa Baba Sata, Yelebasakataha, Yelebaba Baba, Sizeguena Kulukulu, some of us have desperate needs. We are not gonna let this opportunity go. We are not going to let this opportunity go.
changed. Shanda kataha ilamasha kate rekete pesete idazikataha ilamasha yenamaha yalamasha unananana shaka yemeseketaha yemando senaya ushananamaya ilamasiarabaha ilamandeye babababashe Rikato setapakata rando kosete ketaha ilamando ziananaha yalabasa tadi adadadadadaha rakote pakata katosete our destiny is at stake rapakasunamaha unless we encounter you remando kosada ayalaba ilabasete our light will dim unless we encounter you we will have no say in our generation unless we encounter you we will have no impact none whatsoever ekseni ushama hasa asile sontweni sizekuwe 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 elamana saye inanana ungesaka beze yini shaka papapata rekete keseke Sanaya, Hosana Mahase, Ilamaya, Enana Nahasa, Repekete Hetas, Hula Simaha, Nema Sayaha, Inashana Mahasa, Ehena Moyongwele, brood over us, until a new us emerges, brood over us, until you change men's hearts. Brood over us until something rests on us. Brood over us. We can't afford to live the same. We can't afford to live defeated. But this morning we come. Hosaya haya. Enashia hanasa. Nebrahatose. Nimakata patahasa. Elananana shana inamasuena ilabaka patata kudanana hase hey kapuli bopaksen enamaya ha oh God we proclaim the opening of prisons for those who are bound oh kashana masaya we proclaim setting free of the captive this morning in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, that's what your anointing that is upon our life has anointed us to for God. Necessarily, we declare prisons opened that your people will come out free. We declare that those who are captive will be set free in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Sana mahasaya uha ndabra katose namaya lasia unekapata ha allow us to ascend yes Lord allow us to ascend there are things of unasi born there are things that of unasi zazi tell who will ascend your holy mountain who will stand in your holy place exceni purge us sanctify us so that we may ascend oh God we hear you calling us up here exceni we yield we move from our normal we move from what was normal paneka shaya sinamana hasa hey Holy Spirit, we recognize you. Hover in this place. Hey, brood over us. Shaka pataya. Give birth to things in us. He ena inamaya lahasa. Shana manana kapataha. Elabaya damasuya na 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 ne. Ili bahalabasu ne manoko kapata kakatokete iya shata yela manasia
Rabaka dosaya. Hallelujah. 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 Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Hey Shamakatasa. Inanahasa. Enapatahasa. Hallelujah. 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 We thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Emmanuel. Bazalani extended coming at Jesus. Amen. How Bazalani? Are you happy to be in the presence of the Lord? Nina Sizota Inga Saz and I'm Slang, Esna Sona, Jessina Soxensis. Can you just turn to your neighbor and check my camera on the right and I'm Slang? Are you good? Is one shown any right, my camera on the right. And then I'll shout to Amen. Hallelujah, makelwane. Amen. It's a good Sunday, bazalwane. Bazalwane, thank you. Firstly, let me just appreciate the love and Amen. Amen. I have a mother and I have a late father. Petros. I was in the Bible. One of them passed on go 82 and why in 2 years. Apparently, why land pay to no kind. And block Sagani Pawa commander to Tama Potashi she say. Is ya, ne, wa pila and child. Then 1983, come why now. So, but low before no kind, apparently, does no ma, but it's Basati Bakulel, exactly take. So, so ngafika nami yabona impela nje ngeso sididi ngafika ngazalelwe lokushini ekhaya kusehamba stele lokushini sihlale sibuza lo mbuzo ukuthi indaba ngena ligama lesingisi because both my parents abafundile but somehow my parents decided to name me Precious Purity ngathi khomo senkhohliwe langa so man, I think I get one notice until people started to ask, Litin, come like the zoo. They're like, actually, I'm not. I never bengi, papa bengi, power singies, so I like a pass. So go pee pee in your precious spirit. Yeah, then got to share my thing, then got saying 1987, got feel my like, so Jangabe, Gila's born. Amen. But, every time it's a birthday, you are forced to take stock of your life. I know at times we don't want to because one of us into that glares at us. We have not achieved what we wanted to achieve, or we feel that life is a bit slow, or you know. But you are forced, and I can't help every time realize with how intentional God has been with every single detail, the worst, the bad, the good, every time I realized they were all necessary for this time of my life.
So I'm grateful, bazalwane, ukuthi uNkulunkulu singcinile iminyaka eminingi kangaka. Hey, sengina 40 something. Ngiyazi nje ngibukeka ngina 20 something, no guys. Ngilapha sengimavoids sengijay 40 something. But sibonga umusa kaNkulunkulu. So thank you so much for the love, for heartfelt messages. Nabathinta umoya baya benza into eright. Yokuthumela ama kona kunama SMS amahle njangcwele. Ne SMS nje sindisiwe. Ungazi uyithumela umfundisi wakho leyo SMS, check inhliziyo yakho. Nento errong with your heart. You know, so uNkulunkulu abathinta abanye, abanye bathi ikhekhe mfundisi. So ba understand mhlawumbe selikho nxoxo singakuniki ikhekhe nxoxo sikuniki imali yekhekhe ngathi Nkosi ayibongwe. You know, so benza kodwa ke abanye ngiyabaxela umhla 25 akashayini umhlabani. So ke silindile ukuthi abantu abasindiswe. Ukusinda yabo ngifana umuntu ombuza ithini yakho inamba yakho mfuzi mangibothi lo muntu akakushuthi ayazi amamukela uJesu. Akabi nayo nanamhlanje. But Bazana, thank you so much. Thank you for the love. My sons could not really understand what I was enjoying my day because I literally didn't do anything. I was at home. Like literally I was at home the whole day. So my big boys would say, konje sodlana mtopena mthwa siyapheka. It's well, yes, but ke ngicinga kitchen ngathi kuMcDonald's kuze bezojabula. Ngizwe kuseni mangifuthi ngaze ngalala makho umuntu ongilala engadlanga ngoba bengawuhaleli uMcDonald's mina. But nje I was content in my heart. It was a beautiful day. At times I think it comes with age. We are bobons, ezinye izinto ayibona azinhle zona simnandi mase nishuthile kodwa ke okunye nje ubonga impilo. Amen. Bazalwane, you know, liyabasebenzela abalukholwayo. Mina ngithi angisho nje. Liyabasebenzela. If you decide to believe the word we preach, it's going to work for you. No two way about it. Yazi ukuthi before, ngingakabi na 40, ngangiphatheka kabuhlungu when ngibone ngathi abantu abalizwe izwi. Then I realized, I remember I even preached this phambi kwenu ukuthi it's the same seed that the sower I ponsel inkingi nomhlabathi. So I used to feel bad ukuthi how my abantu receiving ngaze ngathola deliverance ukuthi precious you've done what you're supposed to do umhlabathi, it's up to umhlabathi. But kulaba wa good soil liyabasebenzela bazalwane. Yazi ukuthi angibizi babuthele nje azoxoxa ubufakazi bakhe bayangibusisa. Ay babuthele nje yazi le ayifuni xoxo mfa ixoxo wena uzo sixoxela nje. Kulukule muhle woza shenge woza. Woza ngikelele woza.
Thank you, Jesus. Aksimike lo bazalwane. Ngiyambonga. Ngiyabonga bazalwane kakhulu. UNkulunkulu emuhle usenzele umusa nathi kwabuthelisa. Besingazi ukuthi kuzokwenzeka kodwa kwenzekile. Kwenzeke into obekungafanele kwenzeke kodwa ngokuthi uNkulunkulu bekhona yenzeka. Kushuthi ngithe nje mangiqala ubaba uMboye eShumayela la kwakhona into ethi kimi. Kahle kahle mina ngisumnikazwa ama calculation asezulwini. Ukusuka lapho nje sasuka sahamba sayokwenza into bekufanele ngabe sayenza kudala. Sayonikeza uNkulunkulu ama calculation akhe. Kuthe manje nje kwenzekile sitokhu sizama kwathiwa cha aniqualify sidala. Ngathi mina ngegama lika Jesu siyaqualify. Akekho umuntu ozothi emhlabeni asiqualify sibe siqualify ukuthola into esifunayo. Ngempela ngakhuleka uNkulunkulu akuphela ngishi awa. Kwathi uyaqualify. Ngiyambonga uNkulunkulu.
Maya baye bakhathi uqualify yani. It's I think bekufanele asho lokhu akushoyo. Lapha phandle bazalwane sinemoto entshantshana. Yakabuthelisi. Awu bazalwane, is that how we're going to celebrate when it's your car? Awu! Amen. Amen. Amen, bazalwane. I first the Singahlala phansi bazalwane. Kunento ethi yokushoma umfundisi engijokumlalela athi when izwi lisebenza ubona ngokuthi abantu balizwe mase beyolenza bakushiye nawe kade ushumayela uthi indaba mina ngingenza into abayenzayo okusho ukuthi uyalithatha ubanike mase liyabasebenzela so akubi izwi likamfundisi. So when befika izolo kumina bezongilethela i-birthday present. Wenza njani nje uma uyikhola bazo that's what you do. Amen. Ma befika siyaqoqa uyabona ukuthi ba-amazed basimangele. Nje besho nje ukuthi kwathiwa ayi Mr. Telezi siyabothi you love this car but must bear no. So wathi ma bemfonela besho njalo uma na-decide ucima ucinga bekele athi nkulunkulu uyazi siyayidinga le moto. Njobe esho ukuthi aliphilangi aba bathi oh okay ngathi khona okushintshile siseni yakwalify so izolibamba bayoyilanda ziyandi imoto enkonzweni imoto kamfundisi amen amen mhlambe let this be an encouragement to know that our God is still doing it he is still but angifuni ungayibambi le ukuthi when you believe the word you're going to see it working for you. The word works. Bazalwane izwi liyasebenza. Ukhona ongumfazi wento engishoyo. Noma singangabonga imoto for you, izwi bazalwane liyasebenza. Amen. And as well this week we just want to celebrate ngibabonike bonke ke babikeke. Omunye konje useni. Mile kude. Erastenberg uthando nkosana uya uthe akaphathekile kahle wasengeza enkonzweni. No, I'm not okay. So I think this week we had 3 graduates in the house. Abanye bama postgrad, abanye ikhathibe kwama undergrad. We bless the Lord, bazalwane. And the reason why we celebrate that ukuthi we've got students and they came here to study. And it's always a blessing umuntu uma izofika ezofunda aqede. I remember when umini akasekwa ngithi ngikhumbula ukuthi we released the wire. There was a moment when we had to actually pass her in what we call her degree by prayer because there was just a subject no matter what she did it was a subject. I remember coming to me uno nesifaso ukuthi we are not going to fund you. We prayed when she came fundisi I passed. On top of that kwavela umngani kama wakhe ngiyabakhalela abangani abanjengalo owathi khululeka I'll pay for you next year. Because God works. According to Nesfas and her status at that time, God said, why on the verge of upakisha pindele ekhaya? Because degree ayihlangani nemali ayiseko. But ube graduate and on Thursday, Wednesday, ube graduate because God is still doing it. Amen. Nayo nje lengithi ngik-encourage oyitshethi sithanda indaba zakho. Mhlaba sithandi kodwa kunezwi lishow eli nje uwana emva kokuthandaza isikhathi eside. Let may God grant you what is in your heart. At times you need us to say some few things. Masa siyakhohlwa, one thing is engiyirealize we forget. I feel like I needed to revisit some of the things we have done. Did I send amavesi again? Okay. Of the things we have said, we're going to say them, but there's just an element today I want to bring to us. And we had a Sunday, as it is a praise Sunday, and we just wanted to, because it was a learning, ukuthi nibe joyous before the Lord. But I'm led to just once again come back to that. It's a simple component, a simple element that is very important for your walk with the Lord. So if we can stand on our feet, we're going to read. Angisazi ukuthi liphele ukuqala ngethuma inini. UJeremiah chapter 15 verse 16. Can we just open our books, our Bible, so that we read? Are we ready, Bazalan? Verse 16. The words were found, and I did. Thy words were found, and I did eat them. And thy word was unto me the joy and the rejoicing of mine heart. For I am called by the name, by thy name, O Lord God of hosts. Can I check Le Virginella? Oh, somebody so seen. Hey guys, la mehla maluka tuna 46. Then the next one, can we go to Proverbs 15, verse 30? Uti, verse 30, Proverbs 15, verse 30. The light of the eyes rejoiceth the heart, and a good report maketh the bones fat. Then just two more. Joel chapter 1, verse 12. The vine is dried up, and the fig tree languisheth. The pomegranate tree, the palm tree also, and the apple tree, even all the trees of the field are withered, because joy is withered away from the sons of men. Ooh, Romans 15. Romans 15. In fact, I swear to Romans, I don't think I'm going to kill you. But you know, John 15, verse 11. Oti, these things I have spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. John 15, verse 11. These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. Inkosi busisa ukufunda kwezwi layo ibandla lithi amen. We can take our seat, bazalwane. I was actually laughing ukuthi kumnandi kanjani ukuthatha ibreak from ukushumayela to a point that mase kufa ushumayeli uyeza ukuthi kwathi ngastrugglish because there is no flow, you know, kuba mnandi when there is a theme that we are working on. But I had to just bring my thoughts and what has been in my heart and something that I've been dealing with. Amen. A daughter of mine. Amen. And the theme for today's session, bazalwane, is the joy of the Lord. Funny enough, good, I'm preaching this and you guys are looking so like, what joy. But we're going to preach this. Maybe it's important that it's actually a good day that we do it today. When you remember this time sihlangene when we had our press session, abundance na kumbula abundance open doors. We ended by verse Elihu Isaiah elithi with joy we draw from the wells of salvation. And we did mention ukuthi there are so many things that salvation has to offer, but there is a way of drawing. How he has excellent gandam with great with our sing question, yes, sing a kumbush as well. Because the quick graduation, yeah, amen. Oh, yeah, now can you clap hands for him? Amen. Now I remember, amen. Yes, Babu Steve, amen. Now I remember, and put on it to my loss, excellent. Is that mom? Hi, ma, how are you? Amen. Nice having you around. Amen. So from the wells of salvation, we draw with. Come on, Bazalwane. Come. From the wells of salvation, we draw with. And today, I want to show you the importance of joy. When you read the Bible, go in the book of Nehemiah, one of the scriptures that we know, that this phrase, it's the joy of the Lord, the Kamwako. Now, when you read the book, it's the book of Nehemiah, chapter 8. This is after Israel had rebuilt the walls, ne? After being with captivity, being led by Ezra, then Nehemiah, then they built the walls. And umufunda in this chapter, realize ukuthi the walls were done, but they were not so happy. Mainly because the walls were not as glamorous as the first walls. And mabe comparison with other nations as well, the walls were not giving. So they didn't feel like they had a reason to celebrate. And little by little, when they were weeping and crying, in them not feeling so good, Ezra continued to do something, which is what I want to use today. I want us to consider. Little he stood up and he read the laws, or he read the Bible in inverted commas. And in them hearing iBhayibheli and them recognizing ukuthi yey bahluke kanjani naleli iBhayibheli abalifundelwayo, lithi they started to weep. And mhlawumbe omunye ubezothi they were weeping in repentance, or they were weeping because they were guilty. And lithi iBhayibheli when sekufundiwe the book of law that uNkulunkulu has given them, lithi they were reading it and it gave them understanding. Amen. So they were understanding. Ezra was helping them to understand what is written in the book of law. Ingakho again, I say, kuthi they were feeling like, yo, lente palwe lanati, aslangani. And they were beating themselves up for it. And listen, iBhayibheli, all the people wept when they heard these words of the law. Maseliti wase asukuma Nehemiah wathi kubona, guys, instead of us sitting here and weeping, stand up, go your way. Go and eat. Oh, eat is just very important. It's a very important thing. Amen. Go and eat and drink. Master, it is send portions to unto them for who has nothing to prepare. Name. Master, it again. For this day is holy unto the Lord. Master, it need up his soul. For the joy of the Lord is your strength. So we normally quote le pate eti, the joy of the Lord is my strength. But I want you to recognize ukuthi he is bringing the concept of joy ku kanjani. Firstly, they are feeling like, oh, siyahluleka. Things are not going the way we want them. Things have not been well for us. Things are like that and that. And then secondly, the Bible that has been read to us, we are just seeing ukuthi nje sihlukile kunaleli iBhayibheli. In fact, we are worse sinners. Athu Nehemiah kubona. Yes, because the Bible has just been read to you. And you got understanding. There are a few things I need you to do. Stand up, go and eat instead of crying. Stand up, go and eat. And why are you going to eat and enjoy? Uthi, because this day is a holy day. What makes it holy? Okokuqala, we finished what we wanted to do. Secondly, the law has just been read to us. So because it is a holy day, do not feel sorry. Kuna loko, tap into something else, a opposite of what you are feeling. And that thing is called joy. And the reason why, Israel, you need to tap into joy is because this joy will be your strength. Because the nations, any zobuyela kuzona, ziyakweshina nazo ukuthi benenzani. Remember when they were rebuilding the wall, ukuthi there were a lot of adversaries. There were a lot of people that were saying to them, let your jenjobani yaka, yes, a fox will use a kibela like iwe pants. But utsikbona, because you have all these things you've been hearing, a negative, today there has been introduced a new diet, if I can say so, for your ears, which is the word of the Lord. And when you take this word of the Lord becomes your joy, and this joy becomes your strength. Tamil, let me simplify this by saying to you, you will not know the real joy if you have not encountered the word. The source of joy is the word. We have a tendency of mixing happiness and the joy. The reason why some of us are even here not feeling like we should be here, because we think each joy yet is dependent on things. That is happiness, Basalongan. It's important to know, Tuguti, joy is the fruit of the Spirit. When you go the fruit of the Spirit, you'll find joy. Love, joy, peace, bawabai. But joy is counted as the fruit of the Spirit, not happiness. What is happiness? They almost have a similar feeling. Happiness, though, is dependent on the things that are happening. You know, Gaga, Captelis, I'm sure it's beginning of a bechabulizo, begum nandinje, no good job, I'm sure begu special. Because it was a good day, something great has just happened. That is happiness. And it's unfortunate, to most of us, we search happiness in our daily lives. And Bazalwane, happiness is a delusion. That you'll never really capture. It happens when something happens, but it's not a permanent state. It should not be a permanent state. If you want happiness to be permanent, you need to always be high on something. And we've got people that abanem shadow that doesn't last because they are searching for happiness. They determine the strength of their marriage on how happy they are. No, bazalwane. Ngishola ngathi uthola idrug ethile uyijove ngalokho sozohlale udilulu nje. Because happiness, it's a good feeling and uNkulunkulu uyenzile, but it comes and goes, it comes and goes. You can't design your life around happiness. And I guess we've got these nice things, terms we say, even go Instagram. You know, when things don't make you happy, you don't have to stay. Happy, put your happiness first. Guys, you can't put your happiness first. Happiness is like a shadow. It's like a shadow. So if you are putting your happiness first, okokuqala, you are saying to us, we need to do everything we can do to make you happy. Okusho ukuthi Jehova ube nama clowns around you to entertain you so that they keep you happy. Because the happiness, ayiqhamukeli happiness, it's provoked by an outside force. Fanele unginike imali ngibe happy. Fanele ungiphe imali ngibe happy. So ukuthi uma ngifuna ihappiness, ikhona kube khona umuntu ohlale performer. Now imagine umshado wakho ubase kule kuthi akube khona iperformance. Savuka ekuseni siyaperforma khona usisithizene ezoba happy. Semini siyaperforma. Because umake sangaperforma nje usehlinile, I'm not happy, I'm gonna leave. My happiness comes first. No, bazalwane, that's not what you're supposed to chase. But there is a better thing, it's called joy. And joy, it may not feel like fuzzy, like you want it, but joy, it's that thing that keeps your mind sane in spite of everything else. And that's why I say joy, you only get true joy when you encounter the word. Again, Masfunda Gunehemia, they first listened to the book of the law read to them, Angit Bazalwan. And only after the word has been made clear, that Nehemiah comes and says to them, then this joy, the joy that you have received that has come through the word you have just heard, this is the joy that's going to be your strength. Israel, moving forward, you may look as glamorous as you used to before. Your walls may not look as awesome as they used to before, but there is something that now you have, which is called the word. And through this word, your joy will become your strength. John, Jeremiah chapter 15, Sumfundil. Utu Jeremiah, I found your words and I ate them. And utu mangwaza, they become to me, or they became to me, joy and the rejoicing of my heart. True joy comes from encountering the word. You're going to hear me, bazalwane, it's not going to be long. John 15, this is now Jesus saying, it's written in red. Uti, these things I have spoken unto you. So Jesus needed to speak. And why have I been speaking these things? Uti, so that my joy might remain in you. Jesus is speaking to them. When he speaks, he is not just speaking, he's actually giving them his joy. Uthi, these things I have spoken to you so that my joy may remain in you. Masele kubeka lithi, and your joy might be full. Okusho ukuthi I might have itanki le joy. But if I don't receive the word, or if I stop receiving the word, my joy will never be full, because kuba yizwi lakhe anginika lona that comes with his joy. And when his joy comes, liphenduka injabulo yami that is full. IsiZulu liyasilimitha because sothi injabulo. Abanye will try and say intokozo. Amen. But bazalwane, when God speaks, he is not just speaking so that uzothi wakhuluma kahle baba. The intention of him speaking is for him to give you his joy. We're getting somewhere, bazalwane. Sifunde Proverbs 15 verse 30. Can you just put it up for me, please? Proverbs 15 verse 30. Do we have it? It says, The light of the eyes rejoices the heart, and a good report makes the bones. Amen. Ngifuna le first part, the light of the eyes rejoices the heart. In King James, it will say, okay, it says the same thing, the light of the eyes rejoices the heart. I want you to check this. Are we aware, ngithi bakho, we've got medical students here, are we aware ukuthi amehlo ethu don't really see, but amehlo ethu, they reflect. That's why when we are in a dark place, we can't see. Not because our eyes are closed, but it's because there is no light to reflect. Angithi that science, angithi must told. But that should be an easy biology, bazalwane esikoleni. If I were to take you into a dark place and I make it dark and there is no light, you will open your eyes but you won't be able to see. Is it because you are blind? But it's because there is nothing to reflect. And as soon as ngikhanyisa ugesi kube ngathi your sight has come back and ayanga ndawo ukuthi now there is light to reflect. Lezi zinto ezimnyama lezi ezincipha ezinyuke izona lezi ay reflect light so that we are able to see. Now, the Bible says, the light of the eye rejoices the soul. Allow me to use this word. When the Bible talks about the light, it talks about illumination. Illumination. And illumination means knowledge. Amanyama kamakona means getting to know. So you know when ubungazi something and I say it to you, I'm like, oh, okay. And then it's a friend would say, oh, then there was light. Because light just came, you did not know. Just by getting the new information, it's like light just came. And it was a line. And the Bible says, the light of the eye. Ogu shuguti, lento kunento, ekfale mangi ibuga ngamehlo. Esuga ye mehlen iyo chablisi ntlizi. Because as ngibona, it actually brings light. So it's not a seeing eye, but it's an illuminated eye. It's an eye that just received a particular knowledge. And if that eye comes across that particular knowledge, kune knowledge that when you come across, that joy is bound to come to your heart. Simple example. Ngen SMS manje. Utitile SMS sonke sithandayo. Mayi 5,000. You just saw, awakawubon 5,000. Tell me how is your state of heart immediately ngale SMS. You read something, but it brought joy into your heart. Now, do you understand what I'm saying? So it's the light of the eye that brings joy to the heart. So it's something that, not that just you see, but it's something that you see that brings a particular level of knowledge. Utsu Jesu, I have spoken these words so that my joy may remain in you. Utsu Jeremiah, I found your words and I ate them. And my heart started to have joy. Master to Proverbs, the light of the eye. So allow me to do a mathematical equation. Ogushuguti, there is something that when you read in the scripture, that when you come across, that is bound to bring joy into your life. The reason some of us are walking around joyless, it's because we have not exercised our eyes to find something that is meant to give us joy. And you're not going to find it out there. It's in the law of the Lord. As you take your time reading, abafundi Bible will acknowledge this ukuthi kenze ukufunda iBhayibheli ungezwa lutho but akufundeni kwakho uzuthi laze labhora kumele kube ngathi kune verse nje that just jumped on you. And if you take lelo verse ulibukisisa kahle and uhlala kulona and meditate on it, you'll realize ukuthi more than it just speaking to you, it starts to bring a level of comfort. It starts to bring a level of joy. Let's just say you are sick and the doctor just told you, hey, in fact, set your affairs in order. Ngathi akuhambi kahle. You have an option to go and panic. But sikuna bantu ozothi ekupanikini kwakhe kube khona ethi awuyofunda iBhayibheli. And as they read, mhlawumbe bahlangane nendaba ka Nehemiah, ka Ezekiel I mean. Elithi iBhayibheli kwafika umprofeti wathi kuyena, you've got few days, set your house in order, you will die. And when they read that, but like, how? Yafana nami le. Nami kuthiwa angisethe my house in order. But when they continue, isithi story. Wathi uNehemiah wathi ngiyakuzwa umprofeti wathi mayiphuma uIsaiah lithi wabheke ngasodongeni wathandaza wathi Nkulunkulu, I have done this and done that for you. Asikwazi ukudlala kanje. And uNkulunkulu added the 15 years to his life. And uthotha as they read that kukhulethi shuthi singayixoxa noNkulunkulu le ndaba. That's the light that starts to bring joy. So when thina sizwe kuthiwa sizwile kuthi unekhensa, useyezwa ukuthi sithe unekhensa, but usuke wahlangana nento ethi kuphosible ukuphinde ubheke odongweni ukhulume noNkulunkulu. And if they choose to hold on to that thing, the message yekhensa incishelwa amandla kwandele yokubheka odongweni. Because there is a word that when you encounter, that establishes joy in your life. It's a simple thing. This is it. The enlightenment that comes through the reading, the light of the eyes. You know, when our eyes get open to a revelation, we can be assured of this one thing. Ukuthi we start to have a joy that engeke suswe inoma yini. Again, I spoke to you about happiness earlier. The reason why shothina bazalwane umbona nje ngene esontweni uthi oh hayi akhambi kahle umbone qhamuka usuwenza iplan nje bangimla nje sifaye maphuma inkonzo ngiyombingelela Nkosi yami just konke engahambi kahle because ebusweni uyabonakala ukuthi hayi uyagoyish because we have not risen to a level of accessing this joy that will keep us going in spite of everything. Omunye umbona ngendlela khona nje endlaye bejabule ngayo umthelezi oh ingakhe benje namhlanje when you know the story because sikubona ngokuthi indlela yenza ka it determined by izinto ezenzakalayo. But bazalwane, I want to bring you to a level different, which is a level of joy, which says whether things are going my way or not, I am not changing my confession. And I'm not changing it. I'm going to shock people. It's on my posture. Kuna loko. Inga kumtemi bweglesi tate sisi shock before. Kuna loko. I am going to look at the word. Unkulukula shilo. Ngizoli beholder. And say no matter what is happening, I am just going to believe the least. This one pastor that I listened to lately said something which I want to say lightly. How joy becomes a right ingredient for you to advance. Let's just say, let me make an example that you all can see. We are here, we are praying, and God comes and he speaks through one of the prophets in the house. Like, go Jehovah, hamba phambi kwami mimi ngiyadlala hamba phambi kwami ngenaqali ngiyadlala masethu Jesu akhulume phakathi kwethu athi I am increasing you as a church, you're going to see an influx of souls. When we hear that, normally what is our response? Hallelujah, baba siyabonga, sibuye next week. Mine fell by about 15. God gave us a word. And if that word is silivumelile, that word was supposed to be our point of joy. Mas ngena next week, isonke sesingena. Uzo nane nkonzo siyabana ngoba sonke sixekile ukuthi kanti why is the influx of souls? Because what he said and what we see akuhlangani. Then we suddenly lose our peace. Uba wenzinto ngishoyo. Uthola ukuthi uNkulunkulu asibuke that oh ninje next week mane kuthi ugcwale uzobona. And most of us, we think that is us praising the Lord and that is us just being happy. And happy is not a product of the spirit. Happy is not in Togamoya, but being happy, just being happy. You see us, Baba, it's just a pumikonzo, special meetings. But can we meet? We just need to thank the Lord for what he's doing. Next week, Baba, about 12. Can you maintain the joy? The ability to maintain the joy, whether things are looking like what he said or not, I don't really care. What matters is what he said. Because the local shilo is the source of my joy. Ungimige izwi, so that my joy will, his joy will remain and mine will be full. And this is how God works. He first gives you a word before he does something. And today I want you to know, so that you will maintain your joy in spite of ups and downs. And people that will normally see breakthrough earlier, abantu are able to keep their joy when things are not going well. Ngangifunda la ngohana. Ukuthi yathi my mbuzo eh ukuthi uyodaka kuze ube nini wathi no I'm not drunk. Ari uthi out of the fullness of my grief. Shuzikata it's a gcwele grief. That's why she's been praying and she's not been pregnant, because it's been from the fullness of her grief. Some answers will only come to you once they spot joy. Some levels will only come to you when they are able to see joy. Ngoba phela noNkulunkulu, by the way, akayena Father Christmas. You know he's a clown. He's not about entertaining you, he's about his purpose. And at times his purpose means ukuthi akuzibe while staying lo munye umuntu. But what he's doing is kathe busy no Emmanuel exhibition na KG. Uloke qalaza ukuthi joy khona. And every time engayibona is like, oh, she's not ready. It joy somehow announced that you are now ready. Yindaba uNkulunkulu ku Isaiah 45 athi, sing, O barren woman. You will assume you will sing when you have a child. But God is commanding you to sing before you even have a child. Because ukumculela nokuba joyful into ethi sengiready to come out of barrenness. I'll come back and sibona luzo uza makuthaba nofazi ugijima kuqala. Hey, wenzokudla. Uyabona uthi okay. Ngakusasa kuthi le ntate ithi nje kancane. Umona bazalwane. Hey. Angimuhle kahle. Mawuthi uyachaka kagudli. It's just that you just got a negative answer. Are you able to keep your joy? Ngichallenge uDavide wena baba uMavundla. Lithi iBhayibheli kwingane ayikhulela kuBetsheba yokuqala. The child got sick. And lithi when the child was sick, he was fasting and praying. And the child died. Lithi wavuka lapho wageza wadla uqhubana nempilo. No wonder uSolomon who walandela lapho is called ingane uNkulunkulu ayithanda. I'm convinced that's the reason. Because uDavide could have stayed in one place and said, ingane yami. Awu ingane yami. So noma sekuthiwa uBathsheba ukhulelwe athi awu ngiyambona kodwa ingane yami. And then he is not ready for the next. But kwaze kwathi wathi the prophet said, ubukhali ingane iphile. Yafu wajabule. Kanti inkinga yakho. No, he understood ukuthi I cannot allow circumstances to dictate my level of joy. Because my joy is a feature of things that are in the well of salvation. Some of us will lose a whole lot of things when opportunities present themselves. Ukuthi fetch that thing. Let me put it like I hear it. Little you hit a dead end. You are feeling like discouraged. Master, it joy, it are you gonna choose me, no ma? Are you gonna choose your feeling? And your dead end right now, it's actually a path. Umi unjango muntu who's standing by the well. And this well is the well of salvation with all the things you want. But how you do what you do and how you respond to your dead end says, are you able to pick from the well or not? Are you able to fetch from the well or not? So when things are not going my way and I'm found, I have just missed an opportunity to fetch something new. But when things are not going my way, but I'm maintain my joy. Nginjengo mutu standing by the well. Oh, it's okay, it did not work out, but I still have my future. It did not work out, but I still have my bucket. And can I tell you, normally, people that are able to fetch in spite of their feelings, they normally get better things than the ones they're crying about. Simple word. The word we am preaching, the aim is so that you receive the joy of the Lord. Because when you leave this house, how many things that was as you that are busy challenging the joy of the Lord? Abanye kuzophela inyanga azoqala ngena ama bill, incwadi zama bills ukuthi nje sidila ne joy of the Lord. Bekumnandi sithi inkosi siyakubonga for new car, iqala ithi month end. Installment uzonje ukuthi joy of the Lord iyashake. Yazi khona uSatan umelene nami. Uthi, I know things are coming, you know, my finances are coming, my kumigiz, but I bo. Uzo kumigiza, kufiketela, kufiketela. Zonke lezi zinto zifuna ukucheck ukuthi, in the face of all these things, can you keep your joy? Because your joy is an ability to fetch new and better things. People that will advance in the year of advancement, abantu who are able to keep their joy. Can I say Uti, you can have joy, yes, with your tears in your eyes. Ukhala because you are a human being. You see why the word becomes your anchor. Lord, it's painful, but I thank you. Lord, I don't yet see it. I came to church this Sunday. The chairs are still empty, but you did promise us a fruitfulness, so I thank you. So it's, and it can be tricky. Can be very tricky. You have this one Sunday, things are going smooth. Sound is sounding. It bend, it tides. Abakula about time, balale chest and flat. But right. Je, what's your kind? Umufundisi, umutumala, high bad that twelve. Ukalegubekanova, Gashaya, Azobon, what I know we're doing well. Who's the next Sunday? We are Zazi, so love. Who's the son of the morning? Shika shika je. Couldn't bambile nje. Into it, are you still able to maintain your joy? Or no? Because it can get to a point that it changes the message. Umela u discouraged. Uyibuze. Uphumela uyothana lenkosi yini esingayenzi kahle. Baba yiliphi engashumayeli kahle. Kanti I am njengoba ngithe, these are my thoughts and it. I am learning ukuthi zonke lezo zinto should not determine who I am and what God said. They are part of the journey and the day see passa zonke. Kunezinto esike silwe sithandazele. There comes a moment in your life, mhlawumbe akusho as a pastor, where you don't pray for your attendance because attendance is now a given. But you need to pass that level. And how do you pass it? Joy. Can I stand here and be joyful and preach to you like I'm preaching to the 5,000 I see? No man gya iba man gito. Pesa bankis. Masani ba ni ngumnandi. Ni ngbonega no man shumayel kuti. I'm fundi su pumpi. We can't. And if we are living our lives like that, we are missing so many opportunities to draw from the world. I am convinced that Bazalona ne kumbuli stories ka John 4. Little Jesu wa shala by the well. Kwa figo wesifazane. Ezo commands. Wamana phazanyiswa lo bhuti ohleli. Cause kwi well kuyaphazamiseke. Lo bhuti ohleli wathi ngingiphuzisa amanzi. Wathi siyabheka wathi umJuda wona ngumSamaria sihlangane. Wakhohlwa ukuthi bezokwenzani waphaza. Wathi usathi uyaxoxa wabona wathi ngabe umprofetini. Yashintsha inkulumo. By the time eqeda usekhohlwa ukukha amanzi kwi well. But she had found something better. Little Bible, wabeka phansi izitsha zakhe. She went back to the city. Wathi ngimtholile ngitshele konke. Okusho ukuthi this which was omunye angathi was a distraction was actually an opportunity to meet something better. You are still holding on uthi why times ongishada wangeke. Angibacabangi nje abafani. We angibacabangi, angibacabangi nje abafani. You are holding on to that engabe umane wa rejoice wathi kosi kusho ukuthi bengayena noma bengimthanda. Niyamazini uNkulunkulu ekhipha umfana omthandayo enhlizweni amkhipha ebuhlungu. Nentombazane oyithanda. Everything in you, Lord, I want. Izimos it you can't have. And if you can have your joy, you'll realize it says God is saving me. I think we was saying say ilaga ngiti. Kolo putije ngaga ngasanga ngaya ngsay ngan. Gisa ngang church in my youth days. Not now, in my youth days. Manje manje mbola gabus gan kaswa in goba wow. But the thing is, if you keep on holding on to the things you have lost instead of holding on to what God has said, you miss an opportunity to fetch something better. Keep your joy intact. Go and get a light to come through your eyes. Go read. Go find the scripture. Bazalwane, how we maintain our joy, we maintain it through the scripture we have encountered. I've realized that I'm going around the same scriptures like ngathi Bible. Ngiyalfunda impela but kunekhatha zingibuyisela khona. Because I need those scriptures to be my anchor so that my joy is not lost. When my eyes don't see what the scriptures have said, I choose to look at the scriptures because I need to have my joy. Joy is a result of the word you have encountered. Tell me the reason why you get not joy. But sorry, I was even as bold in my mind as I was thinking about this to say, oh, you know, even these mental illnesses we deal with, that will become the source of your joy. Because I'm a trigger. Utrikarishwa ilokyan, utrikarishwa ilokyan, utrikarishwa ilokyan. So soge kwanele sik pate ngop nono. Because I'm a trickers maningi. But inginga, yake sambe si gadi nyawo zetu singanya tele. But when you can hold on to your word. You can hold on to your word. And say, weda ngiabona no mangboni, this is what he said. Because then that word becomes your joy. The Bible, the liti. The joy of the Lord is your strength. But when you need the strength. Amandla ngisiculile sathi amandla ayatholakala ngokuba kuwe Nkosi. But can I take it further ukuthi uba kuye ngezu libambe ulibambe. Because this is where your strength will come from. Things will question you ukuthi uNkulunkulu wakho awushonga ukuthi uyakholwa. Kwabheda nje. Even when you don't have answers for them, you can have a word that you are holding on to yourself. That says, noma kungangenzeka manje, uthembisile lo, ukholekile lo ongithembisile. I can trust him. And this will become your joy. It will become what will sustain you. I know that some of us, we need to leave this place and go find the joy. Allow me to close with Joel chapter 1, which is our quote, and it's a very important scripture. Uti, the vine is dried up, and the fig tree languisheth. The pomegranate tree, the palm tree also, and the apple tree, even all the trees of the field are withered. So there is no productivity. The vine is dried up, the fig tree is withered, the pomegranate tree, the palm tree, and the apple tree, all the trees of the field are withered. Wonk, check out is that. Surely joy has withered away from the sons of men. I King James Ibegata, it is because joy has withered away. When umuntu engena joy, there is no productivity. I tell you this much. Ngenze isi example simple. Jekuta ngisondele duzo tengenkolen. If I give you a task to do and you are excited about it, normally how well do you do it? Very well. But if I ask of you something that you are not keen to do, gizobona nje ukuthi, well, because where there is no joy, ayiki productivity. Second scenario. Some of us M7s are the reason why you are not so productive. It's not because you are not capable. It's because joy is. masivuke kusenze ithu hayike hayike bantu kwasa saya khona oh kathoko hey siza sithi i toxic nje leya ndawo shabantu bakhona ba toxic sizi mhlambe true maybe true but the truth is the fact ukuthi there is no joy now you are not performing at your best ngiqamba mangani bazalwane wenza minimal pay wenza nje ukuthi bakuthiwa ngifikile makuthiwa ngisubmitile ngisubmite on time oh inephutha usoru ulungise ayikho nje into ethi you take pride in it because there is no joy uke wayibona when you first got that job that first day unejoy nkosi ngiyabonga lord thank you for this job ubonile ukuthi ubu ready to move mountains manje uthi hayi ngeke phela ungenziwa kwenziwa ngeke ngidlale bona because joy has withered. When there is no joy, there is no productivity. And uJoel uzokuvezela uma ufuna nangaphezulu, u realize ukuthi kuningi okubo okwenza kalayo. But usezoveza lo line uthi because the joy has withered from the son of man. When there is no joy, there is no productivity. And allow me to stretch it and say, where there is no joy, there is no advancement. One of the wheels of advancement is joy. That other day I said to you, we need to have open gates so that you'll see abundance. This is me trying to get you to a point that you become a joyful mzalwane. Hey, but depressed abazalwane bale insuku ngathi abanalizwe. Aphila ngamaphilisi angana makhona ekuthiwa ama happy tontoni. Ngenxa lapho bane access to izwi. Umuntu uyacheka no there is no trauma in your past trauma. Imanje nje because akakabi na imoto. Uphubhisa ubathe sontweni sebene imoto lokho ebusiso yamayisi. Ayizwi trauma iqhamuka. Yini inkinga they have missed that the source the word is your source of joy. Hence we even have abantu who are in debt because they think the more they achieve is the more they're going to have joy. No, you don't need to achieve and have a lot. You just need to encounter the word. Encounter the word that talks about your destiny. And unfortunately, I can't encounter it for you. I can encounter for the church because we are a corporate body. But when it comes to you personally, you need to encounter your own word. I mean, I'm standing on behalf of all of us on Genesis 12, on Genesis chapter 12, verse 2. That we shall become a great nation. That he will bless us. Master, he will make our name great, then will be a blessing. I actually realize Zolukuti, kunamakama that becomes a blessing. Makulu ngalendle lukuti je, ukuthi uthe, ayi umfundi swamu precious, uisbusi sabantu je, sebe yak tanda, sebe funa genga ye gamo associated nalo. So I'm standing on that for all of us, but what is your own word you're standing on? Because that becomes your own joy. When things are not going well, things can be slow. Hey, things can be slow. Things can be slow. And when things are slow, we realize we have a shesha for a bang. But today, can I tell you, there is a way of remaining. It's called the joy of the Lord. The joy of the Lord. And how do you encounter the joy of the Lord? Through the written word. If your eyes do not encounter the word, you will have nothing to hold on to. I speak this, bazalwane. I know normally sitenda in umayelezi ithi things are going to turn around for you. Well, things are going to turn around for you. Ukuthi nje eventually. So whilst you are still waiting for that thing to turn around, what are you holding on to? Joy becomes the anchor that you need. If right now singa faga into measure joy in our hearts, ingakanani. Khona nje yabezela inkonzweni ngawo mhlawumbe inkonzo yisini. Khona baza badot ikobi joy le nyaweni because they thought things need to first happen for them to be joyful. Hence the Bible says, rejoice in the Lord. I say rejoice. Maselinye ivesi lizothi rejoice always. So when I've received that regret letter, what should be my response? No, your joy. When you receive that, you know, kunama SMS, no WhatsApp, or bona, I read a note. How do you respond? Because you are not just responding, you are setting up yourself for fetching better things. Advancement rely on these things, one of them being joy. Joyful. Because there's no joy. So no, akekho nothi kwena, well, you know, she's doing so well, let's learn. No, akekho, because joy ayikho. Yazi ukuthi laba ibaboya bashaye balabo amanye amabali ukuthi noma bengawazi umsebenzi kodwa bane element yokuba iga. So ukuba iga kwesikhathi sesitsha ukuthi umuntu uyathanda into ayenzayo kanti uiga. Thina ke sishaye labo ukuthi asikho bothered. Ngisho mngeni uyabona ukuthi awuze la engafuni khona. Ngibona ngestep, maye ichaza uzakhwa. Sanborn. They put their lunch box there. Bayohlali uthi bese bafika nje bayine hour lokuphuza itea. Maye bathi konje wenzakalani noma ngabe kuthi uyathanda to promote them. That thing about them is saying no. So noma ubona ngathi joy iba igake. Because Magne Ika Stendo Eti, she's interested. And when you are interested, say, okay, maybe a squint, but I promise you, joy is what is keeping most of us from our things. You meet your destiny helper, Ashang and now, Gaelaga, where is it going? I'm because you want to swing, and I'm going to sow born and causing Jay. Man, but can we adopt it, Dr. David? You know, the best time to rejoice is when things are not going well. My son is sick, let me plead for his life. My son is dead, let me bless the Lord. Mam Kabang Kulugula Sazulin would not be moved by such people. Bazalon never a fortress. Come up here. There is an attitude change that needs to happen. Whether India is born or not, we born in Zangenta, not coming out, no, my Zangenta, but in Togos, it's all I got it deep down in your soul. Listen, Bible, in His presence, there is fullness of joy. God provides His presence so that He can refill our joy, so that we'll go out, see joyful. And Uguba joyful, Akolukambu dance. Uguba joyful, was in your heart, whether things are there or not. Kunezol Bambi. You'll not know true joy unless you encounter the word. That's how many times I've said that. I hope somebody will capture it. True joy is a result of a word encountered. Let's say you are sick. Ngiyabona masa quota ukuthi by his stripes we are healed. But in your mind, I like a regist because you have not encountered it. But when you are sick, you need to go and search the scriptures for a word that will be your anchor and that will be your source of joy. Sithi sizokubona ukuthi sizwile uphathakile kahle sifica sicculelo wena uthi ah uJesu muhle nakahlala abantu abanjalo nibothi hayibo ngobuyagula kubuya nonsuba ezayo yini. They have encountered something that says noma inyama yami ingahlukumezeka but my spirit is intact. Ah uhlukumezeka kancane spirit safarish. Can't pray, yes, no, I can't, guys. I'm too hurt. I can't pray. You don't understand. I can't pray. Sex safari yon kinto because, but uchoy bazalwane is not only your strength. Uchoy is your sustainer. Joy is your sustainer. Joy is your sustainer. When I don't have a reason to go and nothing gives me a reason to move forward, joy presents an opportunity to move forward. Sing 4 minutes according to Utu Paul may tanda zela ibanda kumana lase Roma uti. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. The God of hope, it does not fill you with hope, but what does he fill you with? With joy and peace. But umusu net joy and peace, what overflows, it's hope. Let me read it for you. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. What will keep you hopeful is the level of joy you have in your heart. He is the God of all hope, and when he needs to refill hope, he does not just give you hope, he gives you joy and peace. When you have joy and peace, then hope starts to overflow. Maybe the reason why you are living such a hopeless life, in inverted commas, where you are going around and there is no hope, you are not even sure if things are going to work out, it's because there is no joy. Because only when you are filled with joy and peace, then hope will start to overflow. Hebrews 11, not seeing if faith is the substance of things. Ogushukuthi nefaith incikile la. When there is no hope, nefaith ayinayo substance. And hope is a product of joy. And with joy you draw from the wells of salvation. Azalani, can I stand here and tell you there's so much that God wants to give us? God truly wants to change our lives. I think I like it for me, like I tell you, in a fire's opening, go bunyang, yang, fun, bush, oyang, yabush, but go, and oi, check, I will land the loot, oh, good, in silas, in luck. With joy, you fetch from the wells of life, of salvation. Abazanabang and that joy, Bazalane by a swella. Ungabna joy, gay attractive poverty. So if you hate poverty, change. Ungabna joy, gay affected poverty. Don't you know which is some of the provision that God has provided for us? It's through people, not only through the work we do. And if umutonge na joy, agaya kumundo khalu baset to the work. We are drained, we are seen, the ulo ungalo to toxic, a cut. We're toxic because umasi around you, we feel it. Siyazi futhi namsukwana ujabulile siyeza ukuthi hayi ujabulile namhlanje asijabuleni bangani yelele hake namhlanje akajabulile ningasondeli. How are you going to benefit from people if you are like that? Joy. But joy is a result of an encounter with the word. Utu Jesu, I have given you, I've spoken these things to you so that my joy will remain with you and your joy will be in abundance as you stand on our feet. Next week, we will be here next week. But if you don't check this thing, how is your joy level? Can you be like Job after losing everything? I see, but I know that my Redeemer lived. Or when, if you were to lose everything, so first your camp alapanga guaku. Sibe na manite prayer nga peli ngoba uyakowish. Pasa one konu bishop usifinda buguti, as nga kowishin, let us go through. Yes, you will go, but I'm nga bu wish, agubu through. Because loko wish akilago buwishi wish ngoba njusela ufunuwenza luto. Learn to go through. Going through is part of the plan. You have to encounter things. But have joy in your heart so that you go through victoriously. Atu Tavira, even though I go through the valleys of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Masati, for thou art with me. Leo, 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 Dole is a result of knowing something. If you have not encountered the word, when you go through the valleys, I know, I'm a valley band. Our band, they are wish. But there's a joy deep inside. Deep in your heart, you need it. The joy of the Lord. And the reason why I wanted to say the joy of the Lord, it's not the joy of getting a new job. That's not joy. It's not a joy of getting the new shoes. That's not joy. Well, it may make some of us very happy, but it's not joy. Each joy is tested when things are not going well. Bonus can you steal? Masihlangana nawe. Hayi bazola ngigakhumula inkosikazi yokugcina. Uthi her son died. Wahlangana with Gehazi, the prophet's servant. Ithi prophet Gehazi, something has happened, but the Lord has not quite revealed it to me. Go and meet her and ask if everything is fine. Indlela lo wesifazane ayayikhonsile ngayo ngejoy lento eyenzeka. No prophet could not pick it up ukuthi khonte wrong. Hayi bazani ngizwe. She did not lie, but she concealed her current situation with joy. And umehlangano noGehazi athi all is well. NoGehazi wanga pick up ukuthi hayi man, lo all is well wakhe uneyinyembezi indaba. Umefika wa futhi uyayizwa neconversation akayilahlanga phansi wathi ingane yami nganami. Wathi nje ngikucela ngangani mina we prophet. Leyo ke feel. Kwafa umprophet abone wenzani because joy will keep on fetching better things for you. Joy. Mawuyo vuli fridge la kwakho libona elingenalutho manu ukhubuza ijoy joy uthe uNkulunkulu wami I have all that I need. Uma kukuthi ivesi akalibamba ukukhumbula ukuthi kuthiwe esontweni uya ushered into abundance. Lord, thank you for abundance. Little fridge nekhabethe which abundance. Agazi inkosi yipi but ukushilo mina ngiyakholwa lokho. Trust me, it won't take long before it materialize. Some of izinto zethu nje zilinde lapho uthi uvule ngejoy. Had encountered a word. Father, we thank you, namhlanje. Thank you for speaking to us in a simple way. You want to keep and maintain the joy of unasibe nayo. Nezinto that we'll never get to have until the joy is complete in us. Oh God, we come. Some of us are hopeless in other circumstances of our life. But today, allow us to encounter your word that will fill us with joy and peace so that we may overflow with hope. In Jesus' name, we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Come allow where you're standing. You don't have to come to the front. Come, you just realize, but you know what? I need this joy tank to be refilled. We are in the presence of the Lord. The Bible says in his presence there's fullness of joy. And you just raise your hands. I feel an urge to pray for some people. You have lived your life based on happenings, not on what he said. But there is a better way of living. It's living with the joy of the Lord in your heart. Receive it this morning as your strength. Oh, Father, as I come to you with all those whose hands are lifted, I pray that God Almighty, you release this joy over their lives. Let something come into their hearts indeed. Where there was hopelessness, let the joy come inside their hearts. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. And let it be strength for the journey that is ahead. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, help our joy to be intact. Help our joy to be intact. Help our joy to be intact. Help us to maintain our joy. Ngegama lika Jesu.
We thank you, Father, today. In Jesus' name, amen.